Good evening and welcome to another edition of the reading of the Gospel, chapter 4 and 5. Mark, chapter 4 and 5. And he began to teach again by the seaside, and there was gathered unto him a great multitude, so that he entered into a ship and sat in the sea, and the whole multitude by the sea on the land. And he taught many things by parables, and said unto them in his doctrine, Hearken, behold, there went a sower to sow, and when it came to pass as he sowed, some fell by the wayside, and the fowls of the air came and devoured it up. And some fell on the stony ground, where it had not much earth, and immediately it sprang up, because it had no depth of earth. And when the sun was up, it was scorched, and because it had no root, it withered away. And some fell among thorns, and the thorns grew up and choked it, and it yielded no fruit. And other fell on the good ground, and did yield fruit, that sprang up and increased, and brought forth some 30, and some 60, and some 100. And he said unto them, He that hath ears to him, hear, let him hear. And when he was alone, they that were about him with the 12 asked of him the parable. And he said unto them, Unto you it is given to know the mystery of the kingdom of God, but unto them that are without, all these things are done in parables, that seeing that they may see and not perceive, and hearing they may hear and not understand, lest at any time they should be converted, and the sins should be forgiven unto them. And he said unto them, Know ye not this parable? How then will ye know all the parables? The sower soweth the seeds, and those by the wayside, where the word is sown. But when they have heard, Satan cometh immediately, and taketh away the word that was sown in their hearts. And these are they likewise which are sown on stony ground, who, when they have heard the word, immediately receive it with gladness, and have no root in themselves, and so endure but for a time. Afterward, when affliction or persecution ariseth for the word's sake, immediately they are offended. And these are they which are sown among thorns, and such as that hear the word. And the cares of this world, and the deceitfulness of riches, the lust of other things entering, choke the word, and it becometh unfruitful. But these are they which are sown on good ground, such as when hear the word, receive it, and bring forth fruit, some 30-fold, some 60, and some 100-fold. And he said unto them, Is it a candle brought to be put under a bushel or under a bed, and not to be set on a candlestick? For there is nothing hid which shall not be manifested, neither was anything kept secret, but it shall come abroad. If any man have ears to hear, let him hear. With what measure ye shall meet, it shall be measured unto you, and unto you that hear, more shall be given. For he that hath, to him shall be given, and he that hath not, from him shall be taken away that which he hath. And he said, So is the kingdom of God, as if a man should cast seed into the ground, and should sleep and rise night and day, and the seed should spring and grow up, he knoweth not how. For the earth bringeth forth fruit of itself, first the blade, then the ear, after that the full corn in the ear. And when the fruit is brought forth, immediately he putteth it into its sickle, because the harvest is come. And he said, Whereunto shall we liken the kingdom of God? Or with what comparison shall we compare it? It is like a grain of mustard seed. When it is grown, sown in the earth, is less than all the seeds that be in the earth. But when it is sown, it groweth up, and become greater than all the herbs, and shooteth out great branches, so that the fowls of the air may lodge under the shadow of it. But with many such parables spake he the word unto them, as they were able to hear it. But without a parable spake he not unto them. And when they were alone, he expounded all these things to his disciples. And the same day, when the even was come, he saith unto them, Let us pass over to the other side. And when they had sent the multitude, they took him, even as he was in the ship. And there were also with him other little ships. And there arose a great storm of wind, and waves beat into the ship, so that it was now full. And he was in the hinder part of the ship, asleep on a pillow. And they awake him, and say unto him, Master, carest thou not that we perish? And he arose and rebuked the wind, and says unto the sea, Peace be still. And the wind ceased, and there was great calm. And he said unto them, Why are ye so fearful? How is it that you have no faith? And they feared exceedingly, and said one to another, What manner of man is this, that even the wind and the sea obey him? Chapter 5. And they came over to the other side of the sea, into the country of Gadarenes. And when he had come out of the ship, immediately there met him out of the tombs a man with an unclean spirit, who had his dwelling among the tombs, and no man could bind him, no, not with chains, because that he had often been bound with fetters and chains, and the chains had been plucked asunder by him, and the fetters broken in pieces, neither could any man tame him. And always night and day he was in the mountains and in the tombs, crying and cutting himself with stones. And when he saw Jesus afar off, he ran and worshipped him, and cried with a loud voice, and said, What have I to do with thee, Jesus, thou Son of the Most High God? I adjure thee by God, that thou torment me not. For he said unto him, Come out of the man, thou unclean spirit. And he asked him, What is thy name? And he answered, saying, My name is Legion, for we are many. And he besought him that much that they would not send him away out of the country. And there was nigh unto the mountains a great herd of swine feeding. And all the devils besought him, saying, Send us into the swine, that we may enter into them. And forthwith Jesus gave them leave. And the unclean spirits went out and entered into the swine. And the herd ran violently down a steep place into the sea. There were about 2,000 and were choked in the sea. And they that fed the swine fled and told in the city and in the country. And they went out to see what it was to be done. And they came unto Jesus and see him that was possessed with the devil and had the legion sitting and clothed and in his right mind. And they were afraid. And they saw it, and they that saw it told them how it befell to him that was possessed with the devil, and also concerning the swine. And they began to pray him to depart out of their course. And when he was come into the ship, he that had been possessed with the devil prayed him that he be with them. However, Jesus suffered him not, and said unto him, Go home to thy friends, tell them how great things the Lord has done unto thee, and has compassion on thee. And he departed, and began to publish in Decapolis how great things Jesus had done for him, and all men did marvel. And when Jesus was passed over again by ship unto the other side, much people gathered unto him, and he was nigh unto the sea. And behold, there cometh one of the rulers of the synagogue, Jairus by name. And when he saw him, he fell at his feet, and besought him greatly, saying, My little daughter lieth at the point of death. I pray thee, come and lay hands on her, that she may be healed, and she shall live. And Jesus went with him, and much people followed him and thronged him. And a certain woman, who had an issue of blood 12 years, and had suffered many things of many physicians, had spent all that she had, and had nothing bettered, but rather grew worse, when she heard of Jesus, came in the press behind, and touched his garment. For she said, If I touch his clothes, I shall be whole. And straightway the fountain of her blood was dried up, and she felt in her body that she was healed of that plague. And Jesus, immediately knowing in himself that virtue had gone out of him, turned him about in the press, and said, Who touched my clothes? And the disciples said unto him, Thou seest the multitude thronging thee, and sayest thou, Who touched thee? And he looked round about to see her that had done this thing. But the woman, fearing and trembling, knowing that was done in her, came and fell down before him and said all the truth. And he said unto her, Daughter, thy faith has made thee whole. Go in peace and be whole of thy plague. While he yet spake, there came from the ruler of the synagogue's house certain which said, Thy daughter is dead. Why trouble thou the master any further? As soon as Jesus heard the word that was spoken, he said to the ruler of the synagogue, Be not afraid, only believe. And he suffered no man to follow him, save Peter, James, and John, the brother of James. And he came to the house of the ruler of the synagogue, and seeing the tumult, and them that wept, wailed greatly. And when he was come, he saith unto them, Why make it this ado and sleep and weep? The damsel is not dead, but sleepeth. And they laughed him to scorn. And when he had put them all out, he taketh his father and the mother of the damsel, and them that were with him, and enter in where the damsel was lying. And he took the damsel by the hand, and said unto her, Talitha kumi, which is being interpreted, Damsel, I say unto thee, arise. And straightway the damsel arose and walked, for she was of the age of 12 years. And they were astonished with great astonishment. And he charged them straightly that no man should know it, and commanded that something should be given to her to eat.